this time Les Norman.
You just gotta love this. I know that there's not too many other options out there, but like I said before, Boone is running these guys. Norman's got 13 major league games under his belt, and he's in a position like this where he has to come to the plate late in the game and has to perform for his major league ball club. And hey, the only way you learn how to do it is to be put in those situations.
Let me ask you this. Talking to the veteran hitters like Tony Gwynn and even George Brettman, who's playing for Kansas City, and a guy like Barry Bonds, they like to face a veteran pitcher, somebody they know. Now, a veteran pitcher, does he like to face a young hitter?
I think pitchers generally do like to face a young hitter because they feel like they have the edge. Now, he hasn't seen the hitter either, but a lot of times then what the pitcher will do, he'll rely on his stuff. He'll rely on my best pitches. You know, I know what I want to do with this hitter. I don't really care who he is. I know he's had good numbers in the past at the minor league level. Let's see if he's a big league hitter.
That's the job of Les Norman. And Norman goes down the line. It's a foul ball. Here comes Tucker to tie the game. He's rounding third. We're tied at seven. They're going to send the man behind him, Brett Gagne. Here's the play. Safe. And the Royals lead 8-7. This is a tremendous confidence boosting game for Kansas City. A young team saying youth is served in September of 95. We're in a pennant race. We've got the wild card on the line. Gagne, the veteran, comes through, and then the rookie Les Norman. A double and RBI, his first double this year, only his fifth hit, and he is trying to win Kansas City's biggest game.
Here comes Gagne all the way around to score. You see the way he cuts the bases up very nicely. Doesn't put himself way out past the bag, so he gets the most direct route to each base.
Johnny Damon to left field. This could be trouble. On comes Carter. It hits. Here comes the runner. Les Norman scores. It's now 9-7 Royals. Can you believe this, Steve?
Johnny Damon's so hot right now that even though he's getting jammed on this pitch, he still gets a base hit.
That's usually the result of a strong hitter with very powerful hands. Johnny Damon, they tell us, has just that.
There's the ball, just jams him, but he's got his head down on it. Good hitters get jammed, as we've talked about before. But you look at this Toronto ball club right now. Games like this would never have happened in their championship years. We saw them hit the ball all over the ballpark all day long in game one and halfway through game two. Would never let a ball club come back on them the way the Royals have this year. And that's the major difference between the championship seasons that the Blue Jays have had in the past and this year.
Toronto had 11 straight winning seasons before 1994. They won four divisional titles and two World Series. Goodwin pops it up, third base side. Ed Sprague wants it, but the shortstop calls him up, and Tomas Perez makes the catch. And finally, two outs here in the eighth inning.
This is a team that came in here today that have lost four straight games in Cleveland. They go to the White Sox, they lose three straight there. They come in here and they take the first game, and it seemed like they started to change the momentum back. But you see a lot of blank stares on a lot of players from this team wondering, wow, what happened to us? And you've seen that a lot around baseball this year when you look at the Yankees and the White Sox and the Toronto Blue Jays, teams that were supposed to fare pretty well, and they just have not got the job done.
Now Wally Joyner the batter, and he takes strike one. Wally Joyner was a big hitter in the seventh inning. He reached on an error, and he needed to get on because Gary Gaetti then followed with a booming home run, a three-run blast to get Kansas City in this game. And now Les Norman has given him the lead with a huge double to score two. And he swings and misses, and while he's behind the count, no balls, two strikes. But for Toronto, I remember 92, and they were just getting that confidence, feeling that they could win it all. They had these T-shirts that